Hello dear students, welcome to this class where we will be talking about AUBP and AUBA, that is polyp, abnormal uterine bleeding due to polyp and abnormal uterine bleeding due to adenomyosis. So since we are taking AUB separately, we will talk about palm coin differently in different lectures. So first let us talk about polyp and then followed by adenomyosis. So coming to AUB because of polyp. So polyp can be, it is a structural disorder. You all know it is a structural disorder. So polyp can be anywhere in the endometrial cavity. So endometrial polyp can be there, or it can be a cervical polyp. Cervix maybe there can be polyp which is seen to be protruding out in the vagina. So it can be either a cervical polyp or an endometrial polyp. So what will be polyp is nothing but a mucosal growth. It is a mucosal growth of the endometrium or the cervix. Now polyp can be, what are the symptoms with which polyp can present? Polyp can present with heavy menstrual bleeding. Why heavy menstrual bleeding? Because it is increasing the surface area of the endometrium. The surface area of the endometrium or the surface area of the cervical tissue, the endocervix, is increased. So since the endometrial tissue, the surface area is increased, so more of bleeding will be there during the menses. Apart from that, if it is an endometrial polyp or a cervical polyp, it will also called intermenstrual bleeding. Intermenstrual bleeding kyunki menses ke beech beech mein bhi wo bleed hota rahega. Okay, so heavy menstrual bleeding is also called menorrhagia. So patient will have menorrhagia. At the same time, intermenstrual bleeding is called metrorrhagia. So metrorrhagia will also be there. So menorrhagia and metrorrhagia together, I have taught you, is also called menometrorrhagia. So menometrorrhagia ka classical example hai, a polyp can present with menometrorrhagia. Plus if the patient is having cervical fibroid, then wo coitus ke time pe penis mein touch hoga, so it will also present with postcoital bleeding, will also be there with a cervical fibroid, but will not be there with an endometrial high up polyp. Okay, now apart from polyp, also remember there can be submucosal fibroids can also be there. Submucosal fibroids kya hai? Submucosal fibroid mein aata hai aapke all those fibroids which are arising and which are in the inner part of the cavity. So they will also have the symptoms just similar to the polyp. They will also have symptoms similar to the polyp, but removal different hai because fibroids are firm structures, whereas polyp is a soft structure and can be removed very easily. Okay, so you can have submucosal fibroids, you can also have cervical fibroids. Cervical fibroids are very hard, firm to hard structure in the cervix, and which will also have postcoital bleeding. A central cervical fibroid, which is just sitting on the cervix, is called by a classical term, very very important, it is called lantern in the dome of St. Paul. Okay, means एक डोम के ऊपर एक लैंटर्न रखा हुआ है. डोम के ऊपर अ लैंटर्न इज जस्ट लाइटेड, लिट लैंटर्न. सो इट इज जस्ट लाइक दैट, देयर इज अ फाइब्रॉइड एंड फाइब्रॉइड के ऊपर आपका यूट्रस बैठा हुआ है. सो सेंट्रल सर्वाइकल फाइब्रॉइड्स बिकम लार्ज एंड दे लुक लाइक लैंटर्न इन द डोम ऑफ सेंट पॉल. ओके, सो दिस इज द क्लासिकल एनालॉजी विच इज बींग यूज. सो वंस यू हैव अ polyp, how do you diagnose it? The symptoms is like this, and in examination you generally cannot find anything. If it is a cervical polyp or a cervical fibroid, then in per speculum examination you can see it, otherwise you cannot see. In per vaginal examination, if it is in the cervix, then you can feel it. You can feel kitna centimeter ka polyp hai ya kitna fibroid hai. If it is firm to hard, it is fibroid. If it is soft, it is polyp. Otherwise, examination finding mein endometrial polyp or endometrial fibroid, okay, submucosal fibroids will not be found or found in PV examination. Then coming to investigations. In investigations, basically when you do a plain ultrasound, आपका एंडोमेट्रियम तो ऐसे पिचक के रहता है, तो इसके अंदर जो भी पॉलिप है वो कभी नहीं दिखेगा. इट विल लुक लाइक इन प्लेन अल्ट्रासाउंड, इट विल लुक लाइक जस्ट लाइक अ थिकेंड एंडोमेट्रियम या फिर ईटी थिकनेस इज मोर, एंडोमेट्रियल थिकनेस इज मोर. ये रिपोर्ट आएगा व्हेन यू डू अ प्लेन अल्ट्रासाउंड. सो अ प्लेन अल्ट्रासाउंड कैन नॉट डायग्नोज एन एंडोमेट्रियल पॉलिप और अ सबम्यूकोसल फाइब्रॉइड प्रॉपरली. सो फॉर दैट, फॉर डायग्नोजिंग एन एंडोमेट्रियल पॉलिप, वॉट वी डू इज वी गो फॉर सेलाइन इन्फ्यूजन सोनोग्राफी. सो वॉट यू डू इज इन सेलाइन इन्फ्यूजन सोनोग्राफी, वेन यू डू द अल्ट्रासाउंड, जब हम अल्ट्रासाउंड करते हैं तो नीचे से एक सिरिंज के थ्रू हम नॉर्मल सेलाइन भर देते हैं इन टू द एंडोमेट्रियल कैविटी. सो वेन यू फिल नॉर्मल सेलाइन इन टू द एंडोमेट्रियल कैविटी, योर एंडोमेट्रियम विल बिकम थिक, योर एंडोमेट्रियम विल बिकम डिस्टेंडेड विथ फ्लूइड, एंड इनसाइड द डिस्टेंडेड फ्लूइड द पॉलिप विल बी सीन स्विमिंग. पॉलिप स्विम करेगा इनसाइड द वॉटर. ओके, सो नाउ दिस पॉलिप विल बी विजिबल, या फिर अगर सबम्यूकोसल फाइब्रॉइड है इट कैन बी ईजिली विजिबल बिकॉज यू हैव डिस्टेंडेड द कैविटी विथ नॉर्मल सेलाइन एंड देन दिस विल बी सीन फ्लोटिंग इनसाइड द कैविटी. सो सेलाइन इन्फ्यूजन सोनोग्राफी मीन्स अल्ट्रासाउंड डन अंडर द इफेक्ट ऑफ पुशिंग नॉर्मल सेलाइन विल बी द मेथड ऑफ डायग्नोसिस और द डायग्नोसिस ऑफ चॉइस for a polyp or a submucosal fibroid. So once you have done diagnosis, then coming to treatment. So for polyp, what you have to do is, if it is a cervical polyp, then you have to go for direct polypectomy. Polypectomy means removal of the polyp. So how do you remove the polyp? Suppose this is the cervix and this is the polyp which is hanging. So catch hold of the polyp with sponge holding forceps. You catch hold of the polyp. And once you have caught the polyp with sponge holding forceps, just keep on rotating the forceps. Keep on rotating the forceps 360 degree 4 to 5 times. You just keep on rotating the sponge holding forceps. So what happens? Your polyp keeps on rotating and the stalk gets torn away. Remember, never pull the polyp. If you keep pulling the polyp, then the bleeders will bleed. But you have to catch hold of it and keep on rotating the sponge holding forceps. When you rotate it, it will not be pulled, but you are rotating at the same position. So, वो धीरे धीरे इसका taut हो जाएगा and all the blood vessels वो tight हो जाएंगे and swelled हो जाएंगे and वो टूट जाएंगे. So, it will not bleed. But if it also depends what is the thickness of the stalk. It can be a thin stalk of polyp or it can be a very thick stalk of polyp. If it is a very thin stalk of polyp, then you can just rotate it and वो टूट जाएगा. But if it is a very thick stalk, then you take a suture. First you stitch, take a stitch in this, you take a free tie and suture the stalk. Once you have sutured the stalk properly, then you can just cut it off. You can cut it off with either a scissor or you can cut it off with a knife and you can remove the polyp. So very thick stalk or very high up stalks, you have to take stitch. Okay, so this is all about cervical polyp. If it is an endometrial polyp, and the stalk is high up in the endometrium, yahan se start ho raha hai, then it is very difficult ki aap OPD mein, that was an OPD procedure, but this will not be an OPD procedure. So what you do is, you take the patient to operation theater and you do hysteroscopic polypectomy is to be done. Insert a hysteroscope inside the endometrial cavity and under direct vision, you can cut it off and you can remove. You can cut off the polyp and you can remove. So hysteroscopy guided polypectomy can be done. But if hysteroscopy is not available, machine is not available, you can go for dilatation and curettage also. So it will be a blind procedure. Basically, it will be a blind DNC can be done. In blind DNC, you keep on scooping the entire endometrium and along with the endometrium, your polyp will also come out. Okay, so blind DNC can also be done in poor setting. Otherwise, the method of choice is hysteroscopic polypectomy has to be done if the stalk is high up and thick. Okay, now regarding submucosal fibroids, if it is a submucosal fibroid, sometimes submucosal fibroids also confuse, they look like polyps, so they can look like polyp. So in this case you have to do a myomectomy. Fibroids ka removal ka term hai myomectomy, whereas polyp ke removal ka term ko bolte polypectomy. Myomectomy because myoma is fibroid, so myoma removal is myomectomy. So when you do myomectomy, what type of myomectomy you will do? Again, the method of choice is hysteroscopic myomectomy has to be done. Means hysteroscopy guided, you will see the inside part of the uterus, endometrium, and then you will cut the myometrium, submucosal myoma, and then you will bring it out. So hysteroscopic myomectomy. So for hysteroscopic myomectomy, now here I will put a 3-star, okay, because in NEET exam easy questions to aate nahi, sare tough questions hi aate hain. So what is asked is step w classification for hysteroscopic myomectomy. Means I have to remove a submucosal fibroid. So how do I know, how do I have to approach? Okay, so this is the uterus and I have a submucosal fibroid over here. I have a fibroid over here which has a submucosal component. So how do I remove it? Should I remove from inside or should I go laparoscopically and then I cut and remove it? Okay, so these all things I will know by step W classification. So step W classification is a scoring system. In this scoring system, we take S, T, E, P and W. 5 parameters are taken. Number 1, coming to S. S stands for, this is the mnemonic step W. S stands for the size in centimeters, very very important. Try to listen it, get an extra edge so that you answer nicely in examination. Itna padhane ke baad bhi if you don't answer then it is very poor. So size is, if it is, your scoring will be 0, 1 and 2. You will give score 0, 1 and 2. So if the size is less than 2 centimeter, size of the fibroid is less than 2 centimeter, then it is score 0. If it is between 2 to 5 centimeter, then score 1, and more than 5 centimeter is score 2. Okay, so this is regarding size. Next, T stands for topography. What do you mean by topography? Topography is kaun se part of the uterus mein wo fibroid hai. Ye niche ki taraf hai fibroid, low, ya fir middle of the cavity, ya fir high. Agar higher part of the cavity mein hai, so it is very difficult to remove hysteroscopically. Hysteroscopically inside se jab aap remove kar rahe ho, to niche wale fibroids ko remove karna bahut aasan hai. So it can be either low or in the mid cavity, it can be in the mid cavity, or it can be high, it can be situated high. So this is topography. Next, coming to E. E stands for extension of the base. Extension of the base. It means ki how thick is the base. If the base is less than 1/3 of the total thickness of the fibroid, if it is 1/3 to 2/3 of the thickness of the fibroid, and if it is more than 2/3 of the thickness of the fibroid, it means if it is like this, this is the fibroid, this is the thickness of the fibroid, and the base is only this much, less than 1/3. It can be like this, 2/3 of the thickness of the fibroid, or it can be more than 2/3, means this is the thickness and the base is also this much thick. Then you say it is more than 2/3 of the thickness. Okay, extension of the base. P stands for penetration. How deep is the fibroid into the myometrium? Okay, so it can be no depth of 0% penetration, means it is completely pedunculated, like this one, it is completely pedunculated. Or it can be less than 50% penetrated into the myometrium, more than 50% penetrated into the myometrium. Okay, so it will be basically P. and your W stands for whether the fibroid is in the lateral wall or not. If it is in the lateral wall, then you add score 1. One score add कर दोगे अगर ये lateral wall में है, because lateral wall से लेना थोड़ा सा मुश्किल होता है, anterior and posterior wall से easily हो जाता है, आप कर सकते हो hysteroscopy के से, ठीक है. So the maximum score can be 2 × 4, 8 + 1, 9. Maximum score can be 9 and minimum score can be 0. So the score ranges from 0 to 9. If the score is between 0 to 4, if the total score is between 0 to 4, then it is group 1 and you say ki easy hysteroscopy will be done. Easy hysteroscopic removal is possible. Hysteroscopic removal is very easy. If the score is 5 and 6, then it is group 2, then you say ki you have to go for, consider a two-step hysteroscopy. What do you mean by two-step hysteroscopy? Matlab iska extension of the base bhi zyada hai and iska base bhi bahut thick hai. So what you do is go hysteroscopically inside the uterus. Jitna ho sakta hai aap remove kar do first sitting mein. And then call the patient after next menses. Next menses aane ke baad, phir next cycle mein bulao. And next cycle mein again we do a hysteroscopy. And jitna aur ho sakta hai, we will scoop and we will take it out. So it is a two-step hysteroscopy. In two sittings you have to do the hysteroscopy. Is cycle mein ek baar hysteroscopy karo. And then next cycle mein, jo bacha kucha hua residual reh jayega, wo next cycle mein karna hai. And if the score is 7, 8 and 9, it is type 3 submucosal fibroids and you should never attempt hysteroscopy. You better go for laparoscopic myomectomy. Means you have to approach from outside, because ye zyada thick embedded hai, you approach from outside, cut the endomyometrium, come inside and then take out the fibroid. So laparoscopic approach has to be considered in such patients. This is step W classification. So this is all about AUBP. Now let us come to AUBA. Our next topic is AUBA, that is adenomyosis. Now what actually happens in adenomyosis? Let us see the pathophysiology of adenomyosis. Adenomyosis is called when the endometrium, suppose this is the endometrium, endometrium has embedded into the myometrium. Endometrial cells or tissues have come inside in the myometrial cavity, then this is called adenomyosis. But when the endometrial cells go to outside the uterus, anywhere in the body, then it is called endometriosis. Endometriosis bolte hain when it has gone to any other organ, anywhere body mein kahin pe bhi chala jaye, it is called endometriosis. But if it is in the myometrium, which is a subset of endometriosis, it is called adenomyosis. So basically, when the endometrium goes into the myometrium and gets embedded, ye kaise ja sakta hai, what are the causes, kaise ja sakta hai, after delivery or after repeated DNC. If you keep on doing DNC, aap endometrium ko kharoch rahe ho, every time you are kharoch rahe ho, to ye kya ho jayega, endometrium mein breach ho jayega. To endometrial tissue dheere dheere migrate karke myometrium mein chala jayega. Dusra hai after delivery. After delivery what happens, repeated delivery in multiparous women, the placenta sheds off, endometrium sheds off, every time it is keeping on shedding off, so there are raw areas which are created. And these raw areas will lead to endometrium getting embedded in the myometrium. So this is the pathophysiology. So AUBA generally occurs in parous women, multi-parous women rehta hai. Their age group is around 40s and 50s. Us samay mostly adenomyosis hota hai. Very nully parous women, adolescent women mein generally AUBA ya adenomyosis nahi milta hai. So what happens during every menstrual cycle? When the endometrium bleeds, endometrial bleeding to bahar aa jata hai, but the endometrium which is inside the myometrium, that also bleeds. And this blood gets collected in the myometrium. These blood gets collected because they are not able to come out. They are collecting. So because of which there is inflammation, there is irritation inside the uterus, and uterus becomes bulky and uterine size keeps on increasing. Uterus ka size bada ho jata hai. So once uterus ka size bada ho jata hai and wo inflamed ho jata hai, bahut thick ho jata hai myometrium. Now this uterine size keeps on increasing until the uterus is 12 to 14 weeks size. So 12 week size kitna hota hai uterus? It is just palpable over the symphysis pubis. So abdominal organ jab banta hai, just palpable is 12 weeks, and 12 weeks se 2 finger upar ho gaya 14 weeks. So uterus will be 10 to 14 weeks size होता है, इतना वो सूज जाता है, वो swelling हो जाता है. And these uterus are always tender. There are tenderness present. Tenderness, if you touch the uterus or do PV examination, patient will be very much wincing with pain. Why? This is because of the increase in size and because there is so much of congestion inside the myometrium, there is congestive pain, and so patients near the uterus, all the ligaments are stretching. So when the ligaments are stretching, the ligaments have nerve supply. The ligaments and all the fascia and ligaments have nerve supply. So these nerves get irritated. When the nerves get irritated, then patient will have lot of pain. So patient will have heavy menstrual bleeding. Of course, heavy menstrual bleeding will be there, AUB will be there, menorrhagia. Along with that, patient's main complaint will be dysmenorrhea. And this dysmenorrhea is basically, it is secondary dysmenorrhea or it is congestive dysmenorrhea, as we have studied in our introduction to AUB class. So congestive dysmenorrhea mein pain kab start hota hai? 7 to 10 days before the menses, patient ka pain start ho jata hai, and then it gets relieved when the menses start. Jab bleeding start ho jata hai, tab kya hota hai? There is decompression, kyunki sara bleed ho jata hai, to fir dheere dheere pain settle ho jata hai. So these patients will have a lot of pain during menses. So agar aapko exam mein koi case mile, which will be a 30 to 40 years female, generally it will be a 40 years female, it will be a paras female, like para 3 life 3, para 4 life 4, para 2 life 2, all paras female rahega, ya fir repeated history of DNC reh sakta hai, patient nali paras bhi reh sakta hai, koi live issue nahi hai, but repeated DNC hua hai, and she will have very much dysmenorrhea, heavy menstrual bleeding ke saath saath dysmenorrhea rahega, and patient ka examination mein uterus tender, tense rahega, and 12 to 14 weeks size ya 10 to 14 weeks size rahega, then your diagnosis is always adenomyosis. So what happens? These are the examination findings and history from which you diagnose. Then you go for investigations. What investigations do you do? Basically, ultrasound is the investigation and blood investigations are also done. If you are planning surgery for the patient, if you are planning, there are two modalities of treatment you can do. One is you can go for conservative management with progesterone hormone, because progesterone will inhibit estrogen. And when progesterone will inhibit estrogen, your proliferation of these endometrial spots will not take place. Okay, so basically we have to decrease estrogen in the body, so our treatment will be progesterone. Otherwise, if patient's family is complete, patient is 40 years old, and she is not relieved with progesterone, failed medical management, then we can go for surgery. What type of surgery can be done? Hysterectomy can be done for these patients. Uterus can be removed if it is so much of pain that patient's life or quality of life is hampered, then hysterectomy can also be done. If you are planning surgery or hysterectomy for the patients, then all the blood investigations required for pre-anesthetic checkup has to be done, starting from CBC, blood group, RFT, LFT, all the investigations have to be done. All the viral markers like HIV, HBs, Ag, Okay, I'm just mentioning what are the pre-anesthetic checkups, because these you have to write in examination if asked. Then you do urine routine and urine culture for the patients, because UTI has to be ruled out prior to surgery. You get a chest x-ray done and an ECG done for giving anesthesia to the patients. And also do a T3, T4, TSH. Thyroid testing has to be done, because hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism are contraindications for anesthesia. So these are the investigations you will do. Apart from that, if you are planning progesterone therapy, conservative management, or if you are not planning surgery, then for diagnostic modality, you will do ultrasound of the patient who has come with adenomyosis. So what type of ultrasound, what is the route of ultrasound that we will prefer? We will go for transvaginal ultrasound is better than transabdominal ultrasound, because uterus here is a pelvic organ. It is just 10 to 12 weeks or 12 to 14 weeks size. So abdomen se acha wo vaginal route se acha pata chalega. And I had already told you TVS ka frequency zyada hota hai, 3 to 5 megahertz. And transabdominal scan ka frequency kam hota hai, amplitude zyada hota hai, it is 1.5 to 2 megahertz, always remember this, okay. So transvaginal scan will be done. When you do a transvaginal scan, how do you diagnose ki ye adenomyosis hai? Very, very, very important. I will put 3-star in it, okay. The criteria for diagnosing adenomyosis, this is called MUSA criteria, MUSA criteria. What do you mean by MUSA? MUSA is morphological uterus sonographic assessment. Okay, MUSA criteria. So MUSA criteria, in MUSA criteria you have 8 criteria. Any of these 8 criteria, if it is present, you say it is adenomyosis. So come, let us see all the criteria one by one. The first criteria is asymmetrical thickening of anterior and posterior myometrium. Myometrium means your one of the myometrium will be more thick compared to the other. Means anterior myometrium se posterior myometrium zyada thick ho jayega. Ya fir anterior myometrium will be thicker than posterior myometrium. This can be one of the features of adenomyosis. Jis site zyada deposition hua hai and congestion hua hai, that will be thicker than the rest. Okay. Coming to number 2, second feature will be presence of myometrial cysts. So basically these myometrial cysts are nothing but collection of blood in the myometrium, okay, because there has been blood collection during every menses, so there will be myometrial cysts. Number 3 is hyperechoic islands. So basically it is like cysts only, but they are islands of tissues which are found, okay, like this. There can be islands of tissues anywhere, there will be islands of tissues, and these are all focal adenomyosis, focal adenomyotic blood bleeding spots. So hyperechoic islands can also be seen. Number 4, it will be fan-shaped shadowing present. Okay, so what do you mean? If this is the uterus and you put your probe, ultrasound probe, above in the abdomen, you will find ki there will be fan-shaped shadowing of the ultrasound probe. So this fan-shaped shadowing will be there because there is all the endometrial deposits in the myometrium. They will keep on splitting and distributing the light here and there, so there will be fan-shaped shadowing of the ultrasound beam, okay, in this thing. Then you can have sub-endometrial echogenic buds ecogenic buds. What do you mean by this? If the myometrial invasion is not that deep, so you will have small buds in the subendometrium. Endometrium ke upar you will have small buds which will be seen. Now these buds can also be diagnostic of adenomyosis. So basically they are minute findings, so you need just for remembering, because MCQs come from this. Okay, then you have translesional vascularity, very important, translesional vascularity. Now understand this, understand and then read. What actually happens is, if you have an adenomyosis, a focal adenomyoma, suppose you have a focal adenomyoma, thode si jagah mein adenomyosis, so you will confuse it with your intramural fibroid. Intramural fibroid ki tarah lagega ye, kyunki intramural fibroid bhi myometrium mein hai. And focal adenomyosis, this is basically for focal adenomyosis. Ek chote se jagah pe focal adenomyosis hai. Focal adenomyosis is also called adenomyoma. Adenomyoma. Okay, not myoma, but adenomyoma. So what happens? How do you differentiate between a fibroid and a adenomyoma? If you see the vascularity, if you put Doppler, ultrasound Doppler, then what happens? You have translesional vascularity. Matlab, lesion ke through and through vessels jayenge in adenomyosis. Okay, it will be like this. But in case of fibroid, if it is a fibroid, then your blood vessels will be it will not be translesional, it will be perilesional vascularity. So, ठीक है, इट विल बी पेरी लेजनल वैस्कुलैरिटी. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. दिस इज हाउ यू डिफ्रेंशिएट बिटवीन एन एडिनोमायोमा और अ फाइब्रॉयड. बिकॉज फाइब्रॉयड का जो इनर पार्ट ऑफ द फाइब्रॉयड है, दैट इज ऑलवेज ए वैस्कुलर. रिमेंबर दिस, इट इज ए वैस्कुलर. ब्लड वेसल्स नहीं होते हैं इनर पार्ट ऑफ द फाइब्रॉयड में. इट इज़ द आउटर कैप्सूल जहाँ पे ऑल द ब्लड वेसल्स रहते हैं, आउटर कैप्सूल. सो वंस यू हैव डिसेक्टेड द कैप्सूल प्रॉपरली, द इनर पार्ट ऑफ द फाइब्रॉयड कैन बी ब्रॉट आउट वेरी इजीली, एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड ई न्यूक्लिएशन. यू कैन ई न्यूक्लिएट द फाइब्रॉयड वेरी इजीली वंस यू हैव डिसेक्टेड द कैप्सूल. So capsule dissection is very important in fibroid. Always remember this. In myomectomy, when you do myomectomy, you have to dissect the capsule properly. Once you have dissected the capsule, आपका fibroid एक ball की तरह होगा, एक cricket ball की तरह होगा, वो आसानी से निकल जाएगा, उसमें बिल्कुल blood vessels नहीं है. But dissection and doing adenomyomectomy, adenomyoma removal is very difficult. क्योंकि उसके चारों तरफ ब्लड वेसल्स हैं, एंड वो जहाँ पे भी तुम निक दोगे वहाँ पे ही वो ब्लीड करने लगेगा. सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो दैट इज़ व्हाई एडिनोमायोमेक्टमी ना करके वी प्रेफर टू डू कंप्लीट हिस्ट्रेक्टमी, ज़्यादा इजी है. क्योंकि एडिनोमायोमेक्टमी में ये बहुत ब्लीड करेगा, क्योंकि इसका ट्रांसलेजनल वैस्कुलैरिटी है रैदर देन पेरीलेजनल वैस्कुलैरिटी लाइक फाइब्रॉइड. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. आई एम पुटिंग 3 tick ऑन इट. 3 tick आई हैव पुट ऑन दिस. ओके, नेक्स्ट हमारा 7th पॉइंट जो है, 7th पॉइंट विल बी योर इररेगुलर जंक्शनल जोन. नाउ व्हाट इज JZ, व्हाट इज जंक्शनल जोन? बेसिकली दिस इज द एंडोमेट्रियम एंड दिस इज द मायोमेट्रियम. सो बिटवीन द एंडोमेट्रियम एंड मायोमेट्रियम यू हैव एन एरिया विच इज कॉल्ड द जंक्शनल जोन, which helps in differentiating between endometrium and myometrium. Normally the junctional zone thickness is less than 12 mm. But if the junctional zone is becoming very thick junctional zone ho jata hai, if it is a very thick junctional zone, maan lo itna mota junctional zone hai, more than 12 mm, then it says that there is migration of the endometrium dheere into the myometrium ho raha hai, tabhi junctional zones aapke mote ho gaye hai. So if the junctional zone is more than 12 mm, it is suggestive of a very thick junctional zone, and it is suggestive of adenomyosis. Okay, So it is suggestive of adenomyosis. Now, sometimes, so this is also the 8th point actually, thickened junctional zone more than 12 mm. Sometimes the junctional zone is broken at places. So junctional zone थोड़ा थोड़ा है, थोड़ा थोड़ा break हो गया है, क्योंकि myometrium and endometrium एक हो गए हैं in places पे. So it is called irregular junctional zone. Irregular junctional zone is also a feature of adenomyosis. So these are the 8 features which you find in ultrasound and it is called the MUSA criteria. If you are not clear in your ultrasound finding, sometimes if you are not clear, you can also go for MRI. MRI is better for soft tissues. It will help us to know the size and extent of the adenomyoma or adenomyosis. Once you have diagnosed it, so you go for treatment. Treatment will be either conservative. If patient's family is not complete, patient's age is less than 40 years, then you go for conservative management. You give progesterone to the patient. Progesterone can be given by two routes, we all know. Either you can give it by oral route. So oral medroxyprogesterone acetate, medroxyprogesterone acetate tablet can be given. 10 milligram tablet aata hai, you can give 10 milligram BD or 10 milligram TDS. You can give continuous regimen can be given, or you can give cyclical also, continuous versus cyclical. If patient is wanting ki mujhe periods chahiye, then what you do is you give in the second half of the cycle, that is from day 15 to day 25 you can give, and then stop kar do, patient ko menses aa jayenge. If she is happy ki har month menses chahiye, if she wants ki mujhe menses nahi chahiye, mujhe pain relief chahiye, I do not want menses, because menses aa jayega to dysmenorrhea ho jayega. If she is frightened of menses, then continuously you can give medroxyprogesterone acetate for 3 to 6 months. Patient ko menses bhi nahi aayenge, pain bhi nahi hoga, and pain relief ho jayega. So this is what is thing. Whatever patient is wanting, whether continuous regimen she is happy with or cyclical regimen she is happy with. If you do not want to give oral progesterone, you can go for Mirena insertion also. What do you mean by Mirena? Mirena is levonorgestrel intrauterine device or intrauterine system. So it is just like a copper T, you insert it inside the uterus, and this will keep on secreting progesterone, levonorgestrel, and levonorgestrel will diffuse into the uterus and stop your adenomyosis. So Mirena consists of 52 milligrams of levonorgestrel, and it releases 20 micrograms of levonorgestrel daily. Levonorgestrel, let me revise you once again, levonorgestrel is second generation progesterone, remember this. Okay, so this can also be done. Once patient is not happy with medical management, or there is failed medical management, or family is complete and she is having a lot of dysmenorrhea, quality of life is hampered, then you can go for hysterectomy, because adenomyomectomy is very difficult because of translational vascularity. So when you go for total abdominal hysterectomy, or you can go for laparoscopic hysterectomy also, total laparoscopic hysterectomy, whatever is feasible depending upon hospital to hospital. Whenever you do hysterectomy, always remember we remove bilateral fallopian tubes also. So we remove, do salpingectomy. So uterus ke saath saath hamesha tubes hamesha remove karna hota hai. Uterus jab remove kar rahe ho to saath mein tubes ko bhi remove karna hota hai. But we will leave behind the ovaries. Ovaries agar healthy hai, patient ka agar ovaries healthy hai, and patient is not menopausal, that is less than 50 years old, then hum ovaries leave कर देंगे, because ovaries अपना estrogen secrete करता रहेगा, and that is important for bone health, maintaining bone health, and then skin does not become old skin नहीं होगा. So all the health, female health के लिए ovaries are required, because they are secreting estrogen. But tubes हमेशा निकाल देना होता है. The reason very very important, I am again putting 3 stars. हम जब भी हिस्टेरेक्टमी करते हैं तो ट्यूब्स क्यों निकाल देते हैं? बिकॉज देर इज अ न्यू थ्योरी विच इज कॉल्ड द स्टिक थ्योरी, स्टिक लेजन, STIC, स्टिक लेजन. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय स्टिक लेजन? सीरस ट्यूबल intraepithelial cancer, very very important concept I am telling you, remember this always. There is a theory from Japan, Japanese theory, which is now proved. It says that the most common site of ovarian cancer kahan se start hota hai, if this is the ovary, this is the fallopian tube, the most common site of origin of high-grade serous tumors of ovary, high-grade serous ovarian cancers, serous ovarian tumors, yes, high-grade serous ovarian cancers ka origin kahan pe hai? From the femoral end of the fallopian tube. So from the femoria, there are some cells which keep on shedding into the surface of the ovary. And they keep on irritating the surface of the ovary. So these cells, which are originating from the femoral end of the fallopian tube, has been termed as the stick cells, that is serous tubal intraepithelial cancer cells. And these cells keep on falling on the ovarian surface and they lead to irritation of the epithelium of the ovary and cause high grade serous epithelial ovarian cancer, which is the most dreaded and most common type of epithelial ovarian cancer. So that patient does not develop ovarian cancer later on, so we will remove the tubes also. We remove the tubes kyunki uterus remove ho gaya hai, patient does not want baby, so there is no function of unnecessary keeping the tubes. So that is why we always do salpingectomy along with hysterectomy. Okay, so these are the treatments. Earlier danazole tablet, danazole also used to be given, danazole in a dose of 300 to 400 milligrams daily, okay, used to be given, but nowadays danazole is not given because it has side effect of androgenism. So androgenization or testosterone level increases and patient starts having hirsutism. So generally we don't give. So this is all about adenomyosis. I hope you have understood it. I've tried to make the chapter as easy as possible so that you understand and you remember it for lifetime. Thank you so much. Thank you, dear students.